Okay, welcome to, I don't know if this is my first edition, like my first official edition of, Spoony Tries, but it's me and my brother who's actually getting the rest of the food right now. So a status update while he gets his stuff. I know the updates have been slow. Not making excuses, I've got a ton on my plate, so that's not an excuse, it's just a reason. It has been slow. I did two conventions, back and forth between two continents across the fucking Pacific. Oreo! But the conventions were great, and honestly, I'm still going through the footage. A lot of weird stuff happened to my... I took a lot of footage on my camera on my phone, and I also got this little Kodak thing. And apparently both decided to wig out on me completely. I don't know if it was the SD cards or what. But yeah, I saw some really crazy shit. I saw some shit scared the crap out of me, but, it worked out. I got a lot of stuff from the fans there. I'd never been to Ireland before. In fact, I'd never really seen the color green before I went to Ireland. I mean, everything is green there, and, surprisingly, I went there when the weather was good, because everyone was remarking on it. They're like, Spoony, you brought four straight days of decent weather. What the hell, the last day it rained, which was ironically the day that I took a bus tour to the Cliffs of Moher, whatever. Yeah, it was the middle one, though. But I saw a bunch of great stuff, and anyway, when I was there, when I was in Austria a while ago, I remarked on the fact that the candy there is exquisite. Even like the basic candy, just because the chocolate is better. American chocolate is complete shit. So like even stuff like a Kit Kat bar, it's like night and day with how good it is. I seriously got like probably maybe like $70 to $80 worth of shit, maybe more. I got a lot. Do you still have the thing you used up in the bottle? Okay. Yeah, I got seriously. I just went to the convenience store, or the corner shop, and got all the candy I could find. Oh, all the candy that wasn't something we have in the States. And I was gifted many bottles of strange and wonderful alcoholic drinks, including Highlander Brew, which is the official beer of the Highlander. Also, I got what is probably a vastly overpriced bottle of Bunratty Mead from Bunratty Castle, which is also cool. Saw some fucked up things there. And somebody gave me... Oh, I remember what this is. This is Ephemera, which is apparently like a... Is this in euros or what? I'm sure this was like a really hoity-toity Irish, what is it? Not beer, but, fuck you. No, the, cider. Cider, that's what it is. So, we're gonna drink this. Fair warning in advance, I have absolutely no palate for anything alcoholic, because I rarely, if ever, drink. So, there you have it. I don't even really like the taste of beer, with a few rare exceptions. So, my review of the alcohol is probably going to be entirely offensive to you. Oh, hang on a second. I'll be right back. So, I have a few things to kind of cleanse the palate in case I don't like it. The first thing I did was I have bratwurst, which I like simmered in the Highlander beer. So it's beer bratwurst. Although I'm fairly sure that's also an offensive amalgamation, a collision more rather, of two vastly different cultures. But hey, I couldn't find any haggis on short notice. And I'm pretty sure the stereotypical nature of the haggis would have made the universe explode. But yeah, we're gonna eat some of this. Miles has already been eating it. How do you like it?
Good.
Cooked all the way through?
Yeah.
Okay. That's pretty good. I can't taste the beer, it could. Okay, so I'm gonna try some of the Highlander Brew. Honestly, I seriously only had beer like once or twice in my life, and I didn't like it. So, here goes. There can be only one left when I drink the beer. Actually, it's really good. I'm stunned. I hate the taste of normal beer. I guess it's because American beer is just complete piss water. Yeah, let me see how much, what it's got here. Actually, this is comparatively weak beer. Honestly, this is probably very touristy. I don't know. I'm probably offending the guy who gave it to me greatly. But 5% alcohol, that's pretty low, isn't it? Isn't that kind of what we have here? I don't, well, you're staying quiet. Well, in comparison, the mead is 14.7 alcohol per volume. So this one's going to be fun. And this one, the cider, 5.5. Okay, so it's not that weak. I'm sure you guys will tell me what's good and what's not. But yeah, this is good. I'm trying to give, I don't even know how to be more descriptive in my review of this. It's just very smooth, you know what I mean? It's a lot of, the beers I've had tend to be very, very stiff. Not a kick in its alcohol content, but a kick on how just grainy it is, you know what I mean?
It's charming like Duncan, not grating like the Kurgan.
Aha! Yes. I like it. I mean, I would drink this again. And like I said, I don't even like beer. I think the only beer I could stand before this was, I was in Philadelphia, and I had a microbrew, which is basically cherry beer. It was cherry beer, you know. And I liked it, although you'd probably consider that a girly drink. I don't know. But, I'm going to try to get through this. I don't know if there's any way we can get through all this candy. And, you know, beer and candy, that's going to be great. Well, here we go. Apparently, in the UK, they're very big on orange-flavored chocolate. Which is kind of what this is Jaffa Cakes. And they also like putting bubbles in their chocolate, which we just now are seeing in the States, where like they're like Hershey's Kisses, but with bubbles. And we're like, how does that make it any better? And they go, well, it doesn't. It just has bubbles in it. But yeah, the Europeans are very big on the bubbles, because like the Jaffa Cakes are bubbly. I'm going to try this out. Let me see what it describes it as. 12 light sponge cakes with dark crackly chocolate and the unmistakable zingy orange center. I'm sold. No, Oreo, you cannot have any. These are people foods. Ooh. Oh, these do look good. Oh, shit, I can't hold them in front of the camera any better, but it's kind of like a black and white cookie. Chocolate on one side and just kind of... looks like a Nilla wafer on one side, you know what I mean? Those vanilla wafers. Oh, man, they're way softer than you expect. I kind of expect this to be like a... like a cookie, no crap. But no, it's very soft. Mmm. Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, the orange chocolate is not as strong as I would have expected it to be, but it's there, and it's actually, it's not overpowering. Mmm. Dude, we need to get these in the States, man.
Almost cakes.
They're like, I don't want to say scones, but, yeah. Very good. Yeah. And don't worry, even though we're probably going to only take a bite of all these will be eaten. But what we're probably going to do is, like, break them in half. And, well, here's one. Now, I know we have, like, coconut candies. Now, hang on. I wonder if I can get, let me get through these. Yeah, these are just, like, coconut cookies. I figure I'll know what these taste like. Let's move on from the orange chocolate. Kit Kat Chunky. Jeez, I know it's really small. You can't see it. I know Brad can, like, zoom right in. But yeah, somebody told me, I was like, ah, oh, we have Kit Kats in the States, and the person who gave it, actually it was Diamanda Hagen, gave this to me. She's like, no, like, Kit Kats here are amazing, and I went, like, well, I guess we don't, I've never seen a chunky Kit Kat, which I guess is what you'll be when you eat it.
This will be the most awkward meal, all things considered, after we've finished everything.
Well, I mean, it is a collision of flavors, I grant you this, beer, bratwurst, and chocolate. You can't have any chocolate Oreo, it's dangerous for you. Breaks apart nicely. Comes in one big stick instead of, like, four. It smells decent. It is different than a normal Kit Kat, I think. It's actually a lot softer. I mean, it's definitely got, like, the cookie crunch. But American Kit Kats are very, like, brittle. To the point, they actually made a commercial out of it. A really fucking annoying commercial where it makes, like, this horrible bone-snapping sound. No, this is crunchy and yet soft enough that it's pleasant. I don't even really like Kit Kats, but this is good. And you can actually taste the chocolate, which, again, is a rarity. I actually had one of these because I was starving. I hadn't eaten at the convention all day, so this was my lunch. It's a Moro bar. I've already had this, so I won't eat it, but if you want to try it, it's good. What it is, it's basically chocolate in chocolate. It's like chocolate cookie covered in chocolate. Actually, hang on. Did it have caramel in it? I think it did. May contain... Oh, it does. Okay, it has caramel and biscuit, which is their word for cookie. Okay, so that is really good. It's basically chocolate and caramel. Hang on a second. I need to cleanse... I got mashed potatoes to cleanse the palate here. No Oreo. These are people food. There's Curly Whirly, which I've also had. Again, if you want to try these, basically it's Laffy Taffy. If you've ever had Laffy Taffy. Oh, he's going to try it. Yeah, show it to the people. I wouldn't worry too much, folks. I don't think I'm going to get hammered off this. Now the mead, that might be interesting. What the fuck? That's not what I was expecting. Okay, no, that's not it then. What did I have?
You lied to me.
Apparently I did.
Chocolate with caramel center.
That's it? Give me some. Oh, now I just covered him in chocolate. I totally did. It's flaky. Oh, it is not Laffy Taffy. I don't know what I had to. No, you can't have chocolate. Oreo's down here trying to scavenge chocolate chunks.
I'm gonna have chocolate sauerkraut now.
Oh, what? No, it's not Whisper. I don't know what it was in. There was one thing that was like Laffy Taffy. This is just... Oh, it's tough to chew.
Yeah, I hate tough caramel.
Oh. Ugh.
Plus, I've had about 12 fillings. This isn't good for my teeth.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Oh, this isn't good at all.
No. This is bad. What the fuck is this? This is Cadbury. It's supposed to be good. Ah, it's not very good. Ugh. Man, it's that kind of really... The chocolate is really brittle, as you've seen. And the caramel is like that really fucking toughish shoe leather caramel. Where else do you get that? That's really I know there's candies that like really just
I can't get it out of my teeth.
Like what are they, Rolos or something like that? It's basically like a little like a Hershey's cup, except instead of peanut butter, it's got like this really tough fucking caramel.
He's gotta go wash his mouth out.
Ugh. But yeah, this is our first departure from the show. I'll give him a minute. So how are you guys? Actually, I better cut right now just so I can see if he's okay.
I just need to floss afterwards.
Oh, you're okay?
Yeah.
I'm sort of wishing I'd cooked these brats a little longer. They are a little pink in the middle. They're actually still, they're warm on the inside. They're perfectly warm. They just look pink. This will be my last video before I die of food poisoning. Okay. Well. This is Cadbury Dairy Milk Bubbly. Which just looks like chocolate. Milk chocolate with an aerated milk chocolate filling. Okay.
We heard you like milk chocolate, so we put milk chocolate in milk chocolate.
Apparently. Easy open, easy close. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is about what I expected. It's a big chocolate bar. I gotta show them what it looks like. Hang on. It looks like a gigantic fossilized dog turd. And on the inside, you can see it's got bubbles! Which makes it way better than normal chocolate with the bubbles.
Fucking bubbles.
Fucking bubbles, man. I'll try it. No, Oreo. This is my show. You can't see her. She's very short. Okay, I'll try. Okay, you know what the bubbles do? They make the chocolate softer. Like, if you tried this with a Hershey bar, which is solid, it, like, snaps off, right? But this, it is just chewy, you know, it's good. So I guess the bubbles do something. Okay. And again, don't worry, even though we're only taking a bite of this, I'll get to it. Trust me. Which leads me to, shit, there's so much candy here. Cadbury Wispa. Aerated milk chocolate bar. It's a bar of chocolate with bubbles. I'm not reading this wrong. It's the same thing as this, but shaped like a candy bar. It might be a different kind of chocolate because this says dairy milk, but contains milk. There. I'm not going to open this. Then there's, I saw a bunch of Aero bars, which again, is, it says, its catchphrase is, feel the bubbles. Because there's lots of bubbles on the cover. I know you can't see. But the candy bar itself looks a lot like the bubbly, except it's got a cross section. Oh my god, 221 calories.
Jesus.
I got to cleanse the palate again. Okay. Except in the cross section, it's not brown in the middle like the orange chocolate on the cookies was just it looked like chocolate. No, this is orange on the inside. And it's the new limited edition. You gotta get yours now, because they can't keep making these. People are dying. Oreo. Whoa. I know why it's all broken up like that. It's kind of like it looks like a butt, but it's so it breaks apart. Yeah, dude, hang on.
this actually looks kind of nasty.
It's like styrofoam inside your candy.
Yeah, it looks like... Actually, the bubbles are kind of pretty, but the coloring is really unattractive. It looks like, not styrofoam. What does it look like? It looks like, insulation? Like roof insulation?
I don't know. I'll try it. You are in the way. Okay, here we go. Oh, wow.
It's like dried sherbet ice cream.
Mmm. Very good. Very good. I don't know if I like it yet. Mmm. Yeah. Oh, man, that's... The orange is way stronger than the Jaffa cakes. Jaffa cream! But yeah, it's very soft, and the orange is way more intense. I don't even think this is orange chocolate. It's like whatever the orange filling is covered in chocolate. So it's not orange flavored chocolate. It is orange and chocolate. So there you go. It's good, but I would never have like more than one square of this at a time. Yeah. So, wow. For me, that's intense orange, man. That's extreme.
One for Michael Ironside.
Hmm. General Katana. Mm. There can be only me. Man, I gotta feel the quickening. I'm gonna have to drink a lot more of this to feel the quickening, I think. Mmm. Okay. Now, we already did the Wisp. Terry's Chocolate Orange Milk. I told you they love the orange chocolate. Like, we don't have any of that here. You've ever seen an orange chocolate bar in the States?
No.
Jesus. I don't know, I gotta get warmed up to this one. Hang on. Because otherwise it's all going to run together, you know? Yeah, Oreo's throwing a fit over there. Hang on. I don't know if I want to eat this one yet.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, that'll be good. Sugar, skim milk powder, cocoa butter, cocoa mass, orange oil, vanilla. Okay, hang on. You can't get this in the States. I'll show you. Hang.
This is Walker's Prawn Cocktail Potato Chips. The logo is exactly like the Lay's potato chip logo, but it's Walker's. And Prawn Cocktail with 100% British potato. Come on, focus, you bitch. Flavor potato crisps exclusive. Okay.
I gotta see what else it says. If it says anything. 100% British potatoes. No artificial colors or preservatives. Contains sugar and sweetener. Which sounds like an artificial preservative. Okay. It contains flavoring. I'm sold.
Doesn't everything?
I guess. It smells like barbecue chips. Like I said, my palate sucks, so... They kind of look like barbecue chips, too. So, I mean, they look like potato chips, of course. Yeah, standard. Hard to nail down, isn't it? It's not bad. I don't know, this one's tough.
Well, it's not a bad flavor.
No.
You still question why it's in your mouth.
Mmm. I tell you, I'm not getting prawns out of this.
Maybe the cocktail sauce.
No, I'm not getting that either. Really, to me, it tastes like the, man. Honestly, it tastes like the sour cream and chives potato chip. No? Just to me. They're good.
I wouldn't go that far.
No? I like them. But good luck finding them in the States. I don't know. I could see getting a craving for these. I wouldn't get like a whole big fuck off bag of them.
For the States, they just need to label it mystery flavor.
No, hang on. This is weird. I get sour cream and onion out of this. Okay. Hang on. Oh, yeah, see if you have them. Oh! This looks badass. Lion by Nestle. But it's got this badass lion on it. Okay, what does a lion taste like? Filled wafer, caramel, and cereals covered in milk chocolate. What is a filled wafer? Oh, we're gonna ride the lion. That just sounds like a candy bar you'd want to eat, right? Whoa. Oh, this looks like a turd. I know you could say that about any candy bar. This looks like a really lumpy turd. Okay.
Yeah, it's just a payday.
Yeah, it's just a payday bar.
It's good.
Oh, no. I don't think you want to try this one. It's got that really... Well, it's not nearly as tough as the other caramel. It looks like a Twix bar. There, I'll show you the kind of the cross section of it.
You see that? It's got, you know, it's the chocolate, caramel, and then like two cookie wafers
on the inside of there.
And it's got Rice Krispies.
Yeah. Like Rice Cookie. Oh no, okay, Rice Krispies. That's what the little lumps are. This is definitely better than the... What the fuck was that stuff? Curly Whirly. This shit is terrible.
Fuck your teeth is what it should be called.
Ugh. It's okay. It's just kind of a chewier version of a Twix bar, you know? This is pretty standard stuff, you know what I mean? Like, you could find this anywhere. It's just a different name. Which, honestly, is kind of a first for... You know, a lot of these candies are not at all similar to stuff you'd get in the States, right? Like, I don't know if you can really find a Moro bar, which, again, is it's chocolate and caramel, and then chocolate cookie. You know, I never see all that much. Like, maybe you could argue, like, a Three Musketeers bar is a little like that. Maybe, but this was actually very interesting. It almost tastes like, you know what it's like? It's like eating a brownie. That's what it was like. You know, with, you know, there's caramel in it, of course, but that was like the same consistency. It was good. I like, this is very good. I know you can't see it, but it just looks like a chocolate bar. What? Oh no. This one is purely Irish. Because it says, love Irish food. So, although it's not entirely Irish, it's also Turkish. And then you've got the, it won't focus, but
It says, love Irish food. Oh my god, this is 225 calories per bar. I don't know what Turkish is, but if you see, it's got like this, it's got the chocolate, and then there's like this red center.
Okay, we'll see. This is a terrible meal I've inflicted on you. Milk chocolate with Turkish delight filling. Made in Ireland since 1933, when the Turks invaded Ireland and took over much of the land. Maybe it's just a name they made up for it. I don't know. Like when they went to Istanbul.
This better be delightful.
Well, it's Turkish delight, so fucking A, man. And it's Cadbury, so I've heard Cadbury's really good. Okay, oh. Oh, this smells nasty. Here. It doesn't smell good, does it? It
smells like some cars I've been in.
Ugh. I don't know if I want to. Yeah, you
taste like some cards I've been into.
Well, what's it supposed to, what's Turkish del- okay, I'll just bite into it. Hang on, I need I've killed my Highlander beer. What should I try next? Should I try the apple cider or the bun ratty mead? The drink of the High Kings of Ireland. Shit, I'll try this. Give me the thing. Oh, wait, no, I think it unscrews. Here we go. Handcrafted in Ireland. I've actually had mead once before. It was like drinking honey, although I expect that's pretty much what the experience is like. Isn't that basically what it is? It's like, you know, it's fermented honey, right? Oh, you want us to see it? Okay. He's going to get a glass. He wants to try it too. Which is fun. Right, let me see some other candies here. Yorkie. The Yorkie original. Crunchy. And Bounty. Which honestly just looks like it's a Mounds bar. It's coconut and milk chocolate. It's Mounds. I mean, I could try it, but it's a Mounds bar. Okay, you got a glass? Yeah, I'm putting a mug, okay. It's Mythbusters mug. Here we go. I finished chewing this. I know people kept, I got a bunch of complaints that you're like, you're eating on camera and that's stupid, it's horrible. Well, this is what we do here, you know, right? Oh, hang on, I gotta eat the Turkish delight.
I'm looking that up, by the way.
Ugh! It's... I can't even place it.
Consists of dates, pistachios, and hazelnuts or walnuts bound into the gel.
Honestly, it smells like one of those trees. Not like a pine tree, but one of those things you hang from the rearview mirror. Except it's not one of the pine trees. It's like one of those horrible strawberry ones that doesn't smell like strawberries at all. It smells like one of those not pine tree air fresheners. I'm not making any sense. Oh. Oh. That's bad.
Needle burn the pain away.
Mmm. That's so bad. God damn it. I can't even choke it down with bread. That's filthy. What the fuck is this stuff? Cadbury Dairy Milk, Turkish. Ireland, you gotta stop this shit. Ugh. So not only does this taste fucking nasty, it's like loaded with calories. Ugh. Wait. To find out why your pack is spotty or stripey, visit www.spotsversusstripes.com. Who gives a fuck? This isn't exactly like the Adventures of Captain Crunch, you know? Like,
well, they better make it damn whimsical, because I'm looking it up.
Are you going to Spots versus Stripes? There's the link.
All right.
It smells good. Here we go. I didn't like the taste of mead the first time I tried it, so I'm kind of apprehensive. Oh, wow. It's good, but man, that's intense. Hang on, I'll give it another try. That raised the hairs on my arms. Yeah, it tastes like honey. It tastes like drinking really fucking, like, sharp honey. I mean, that's what it is, right? It's like alcoholic honey. It's fine. I mean, it, for me, it's a sipping drink, though. Like, I couldn't see, like, hammering down. Like, you know how in the movies or in, like, D&D games, they're like, oh, people are raising huge tankards of mead. I couldn't slam that down.
Hennigan's.
I couldn't slam down a whole tanker to that shit.
I missed my chance to win tickets to the Summer Olympics.
Oh. I did. I almost stayed at the Summer Olympics because fucking Heathrow. I know, Oreo.
We'll go back to the source for a little bit.
God damn. That Turkish delight was fucking terrible. Turkish delight my ass. Okay, we had the... This is a big arrow orange. Whoa. Almost lost the mead there. I almost want to crack the second one open. Highlander Brew. It's pretty good. Although, I think I'll save it. Special occasions. You know, next time I go... watching the TV show. You know, honestly... And this is just me. Again, no palate. But I don't think anyone who drinks, like, Guinness or any kind of, like, I don't want to say authentic, but, like, traditional beers, I don't think they'd be impressed with this. You know, it's actually, for me, it's good because it's weak. I think it's a weak beer. But... Again, I'm sorry, like, whoever gave it to me, if this is like, this is the finest brew in Scotland! Like, you have offended my family and my clan, sir! No, I didn't mean that, but, like, it seems like something a tourist would buy. Like, oh, I like Highlander, that's a great movie. And no, it doesn't have Connor McLeod of the Clan McLeod on it, it just has, like, a coat of arms on it. It's, wait.
Does it have Quentin on there?
No. This is a fraud. This is not made in the hills of Scotland. It's been brewed in South River, Ontario, Canada. Canada? What monstrosity is this?
It's been brewed in the same place as the TV show.
Oh, our TV is activated. Mute it. No, it's... Oh, good. I don't know how you did that. This is not Highlander Brew. It's Canadian Brew. This is like Molson's in a bottle. Filthy swill. No. I like it. We're actually just about wrapped up with this. Fucking hell, man. Wait. Cadbury. Man, Cadbury makes everything. Ugh. I had too much fucking chocolate. Okay, Cadbury Twirl. 2 milk chocolate fingers. That's it.
Where are those fingers going?
It's just sticks of chocolate. Why is it a twirl? The intense chocolate hit. Contains milk, sugar, cocoa butter, cocoa mass flavorings. It's probably like, it's probably like the shape of its twirl, but this is just a stick of chocolate. I don't even, okay. I'll open it. God damn, I'd eat two of those lion bars before. You can open that. That's the coconut cookies. You want to smell it, Oreo? You can't see Oreo. She's kind of patrolling. She's just as high as the table, so you can probably see her ears occasionally. No, they don't give her meat. Are you mad? What the fuck is this? What the fuck? That's weird, man. Look at that. It's like some Cthulhoid chocolate bar. It's like the inside of this is a portal into a weird, twisted dimension of madness and chocolate.
Like if a chocolate bar had muscles and sinew.
Yeah, this is like if there was like a man made of chocolate, and then like you cut him in half, or you cut his fingers off, and then you could see like the blood vessels and like strips of muscle inside. You gotta see this shit. Look at this.
I don't, like I said, it's having a hard time focusing, but hang on, I see if I can get this closer. Ah, fucking hell, focus. Okay, can you see, like, the inside of it? It's all, it's like ribbons of chocolate that are, like, just piled in there. It's, I've never seen anything like this. Isn't that weird?
I'll try it. It the texture's got to be unique, if nothing else. I'm sorry, I don't eat this much candy. I'm actually not much of a sweets guy. It's a chocolate bar. You know? Taxi. Which are 9 milk chocolate caramel wafers. Each bar contains 130 calories. I'm going to be so fat. Eat healthily. Snacks can be enjoyed as part of a balanced diet and healthy lifestyle, unless you are eating taxis. Okay, what's in it? It's McVitie's Taxi. We take every care to ensure that McVitie's Taxi reaches you in perfect condition. And there's the... Enjoying your favorite McVitie's biscuits is even more rewarding if you join the mcvities.co.uk/VIP club for more details. You too could join the Taxi Fan Club. No, the VIP Club.
Yeah.
Very important, taxi people. No artificial colors or flavors. No hydrogenated vegetable oil. I can't believe I'm doing this. Honestly,
that makes it all good.
I don't think I can't eat any more chocolate. I don't want any more chocolate. I just want to eat my bratwurst, which was made in Highlander beer.
And he's not even doing anything. I'm training, okay? I'm supposed to go running or later.
Well, you don't have to eat it.
That's scrapped. Unless I want to be.
Well, you got no. You gotta burn this shit off now. You're only taking a bite. It's not like you're getting like all of it. Seriously, each bite is like 10 calories.
I've had bratwurst, garlic, potatoes, prawns, sauerkraut, caramel beer.
Oh come on, a bratwurst isn't gonna kill you.
I'm saying it's a melting pot. It's about to boil over.
Yeah, this was a bad choice. Milk chocolate was a bad choice. I'm really not getting hammered. It's just I haven't... Seriously, one beer, really? But no, I'm kind of getting giggly because I'm just so sick of chocolate right now. Oh, wow. This is too sweet. it's way too sweet. I can't, like, it's not the alcohol, although that's a kick in the head, but it's just like, it's not like eating sugar, but it's like, I don't know, I know this sounds stupid, but it's like just taking a bottle of honey and being like, you just would never do that. And honestly, this taxi bar doesn't look like I expected it to. It looks like a Twix bar, again, I know.
But these are Reese's sticks.
No, you know what it is? You know what it is? It's a, you know those sugar wafers?
They're Reese's sticks, except without peanut butter. It's chocolate on it.
No, I got to show them the cross, because this is what it is. This is, you know those white, I can do this. But you got, like, you can see kind of the cross-section of it. Here we go. You know what they are, but you may not know them by that name. Sugar wafers. They've got, like, this very horrible white cream filling, and it's got, like, those textured grid-like sugar cookies, you know? All right, I'll show them. If it focuses, they'll know what I mean. You remember cookies like this? The sugar, you know, just sugar wafers, you know what they're. And this looks like chocolate over sugar wafers. Are you dunking the coconut in the mead?
Uh-huh.
Ew. Yeah, that's what it is. It's
definitely not bad.
That's what it, actually, taxis are good. I would join the VIP club. These are probably horrible for you. In fact, I know they are. But yeah, that's what it is. It's the sugar wafers and caramel kind of wrapped in chocolate. Simple enough, right? But it's good. I mean, although, that's assuming you like the sugar wafers, which are literally nothing more than just compressed bars of sugar. So this is like, if you want to get a sugar rush, this is it. Like, this is just compacted sugar in chocolate. I'd hate to crack this open because I know I'm not going to finish it. And I actually really like cider. Like, if I ever drink anything at a bar, I usually get the cider because it tastes good. Like, it's got alcohol in it. And actually, when I went to Chicago for, Suburban Nights. When I shot Suburban Nights, I got this, like, 20-ounce bottle of cider. It was pear cider. What I didn't know was, this shit was seriously, like, 20% alcohol. This was, like, fucking stiff cider. And I got through two bottles of it, not knowing that, because the last cider I had was like this. It was, like, 5.5% alcohol. But no, this shit was fucking loaded. And so, like, two bottles in, you know how some people don't realize they're drunk? No. I realized all of a sudden, I was like, finish off my second bottle, I was like, oh shit, I am so fucking hammered right now. And like, it was funny because like, you know that Star Trek episode, The Naked Time, where like they're all drunk and they're doing stupid things? Like, I could feel the urge to say really stupid things, but I was like, and they didn't seem stupid at the time, like, you know, making jokes and shit, but I was like, I'm so drunk, if I talk, they'll know I'm saying stupid things, and they'll embarrass me. So I just went really quiet all of a sudden. I was like, I can't talk. I got funny things I want to say, but I'm so drunk, they're probably not that funny, so I'll just shut up. And so everyone thought I was, like, really pissed off or something, because I was, like, I was at the table just going, don't talk, don't talk, don't talk. Yeah, I'll fuck it, I'll do it. It's got this foil. I don't know. You can tell how much I drink, right? Here, take a shot at it. You can probably break it off. I'll try the coconut. We don't actually have, I don't remember. We probably have them in the States, but I've never bought any.
This honestly looks like another one of those just piles of sugar. It's actually very soft. It looks like, you know what it looks like? It looks like a cookie with actually kind of interesting texture. It looks like, and coconut sprinkled over a marshmallow. Am I wrong in that?
Yeah.
Is it like marshmallow?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
That's actually not a bad idea. I've definitely never seen anything like this, or at least I wasn't looking for it. It's not very good. Better, I can't even...
Better if you dunk it in mead.
I honestly can't taste the coconut at all. It just tastes like a cookie with marshmallow on it. Really, if you covered it, like, if you put chocolate on it, you just have a s'more. Alright, thanks, my man. Ephemera Pum Dapple. Beer on Lees. This is so not beer, it's cider. Actually, fuck, it smells like beer. I thought this was cider. Hang on. Le Fenere Pomme is made in honor of this great fruit. Its lively effervescence, fresh and refreshing taste, as well as its Granny Smith apple nose... What? Its effervescence, fresh and refreshing taste, as its Granny Smith apple nose, combine to offer you a unique sensory experience. It pairs extremely well with goat's milk, cheeses, pork, or duck. I see no bratwurst anywhere on that list, although I fucked up the entire palate with the fucking coconut wafers and mashed potatoes. I try, okay? I tried. It has known such a success that you will now be able to appreciate its taste all year long.
Cheese? I don't feel like that.
Well, you've got cheese? You better not be breaking out slices of American cheese.
Bad.
We're gonna... Apparently this is like really fancy pants stuff, and he's gonna break out individually wrapped slices of American cheese. Which Oreo is really into. Would you like a slice of cheese, Oreo?
Does she have cheese?
I don't know. No, actually, no, I know, because the vet told me that they're basically lactose intolerant. You want some?
Yeah.
Is your milk in there? Oh, yeah.
Drained it.
Oh, this is beer. This is no doubt. I don't know why. I guess it's like apple beer, you know, kind of that thing.
I'm going to eat this American cheese. This weak-ass American cheese. This is like Kraft 99% milk
cheese.
I'm sorry, it's the fucking chocolate repeating on me.
Oh god.
You don't like it?
Cheese was a bad choice.
Yeah, I told you, right? I don't know, yeah. It's definitely a heavier beer taste. Like, I guess it's hops that you're tasting, grain and hops. There's definitely more of a taste of that. I'm not really getting the Granny Smith apples.
It's just smell.
It's good. Yeah. The first taste wasn't that good, but I'm getting it. It's probably a... I'm so ignorant about beers, but it's probably like a darker taste a little bit, you know, that... It's probably like a little heavier than the Highlander Brew. You know, the Highlander Brew is a little weaker. Like I said, this is a little, like, 25% stronger kind of taste, kind of the hops taste. But I'm not really getting the apple. Yeah, you're right. It's only in the smell, really. Like, I can smell it. Hang on. Actually, you know what's funny? Is it doesn't actually say it tastes like apple.
It's a trip for your nose.
Yeah, it says, its lively effervescence, fresh and refreshing taste, as well as its Granny Smith apple nose, combine to offer you a unique sensory experience. So, it tastes like beer, but it smells like beer and apples, which is a unique sensory experience. I can't say they lied. It's good. Oh my god, is there anything else we got? The best thing I've had so far is the... Oh shit, we got... What is this?
Bar.
There, you try that. What is that?
Milky Bar?
Milky Bar. Nestle. And I've got, what flavor is this?
What the hell is this?
What the fuck? It's white chocolate. Isn't it? Milky Bar recipe.
Old cow's milk that's been dried, cocoa butter, whey powder.
Is this white chocolate?
No.
It's white chocolate.
Yeah.
It's just it's a bar of white chocolate. Now this, I don't know. I want to say mint, but it doesn't actually say.
No, it says in the ingredients or whatever. Mint.
Oh, it does? Smooth milk chocolate filled with minty bubbles. I don't know. I can't take any more chocolate, dude. I really can't.
Vispa Gold.
This reminds me, one of my favorite reality shows, and I don't like reality TV at all. Like, I think the only reality TV I watch is, like, Hell's Kitchen. And I seriously only watch Hell's Kitchen ironically, because it's actually so bad. And I don't watch American Idol, I don't watch The Voice, I don't watch The X Factor, I don't watch any of that shit. But one I really liked is Solitary. What is that?
What? Chocolate and caramel.
And you didn't like?
Bubbly chocolate and caramel.
Of course it has bubbles. This is Europe!
Fucking bubbles.
You gotta have the fucking bubbles. What do those fucking Yanks have? They...
Just solid chocolate.
Solid chocolate. Fucking wankers. Now we're gonna have our fucking Turkish delight shit. We're gonna fill it with some nasty... Big pudding shit, and it's chocolate and caramel, isn't it?
Pretty much.
Yeah. What is this called? The that's not what it was.
Taxi.
No.
I lost it.
It's all the same. I don't. Oh, not Lion. Not Kit Kat Chunky.
Oh, there's the Wispa Gold.
Wispa Gold. I mean, is it good or is it just normal? Okay.
Normal.
What was a Yorkie? Hang on. I think I figured out what a Yorkie was. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is basic.
Chocolate orange.
No, we already had chocolate orange.
Wispa?
Was that a Wispa Gold you had?
Yeah, Wispa Gold was...
This is just a normal Wispa. What is a basic Wispa?
I think it's just the chocolate.
Is it? Yeah, we went over this. It's just a solid aerated, it's a bubbly milk chocolate bar. So the gold is the caramel. Yeah. Okay. This is the last one. I don't want to... Okay, anyway, let me finish my story. The show I really liked is called Solitary, which basically there's like 8 people in these really small rooms, and there's like a it's not a computer, but it has the voice of like a GLaDOS computer, and several times over the course of like a week they sleep, they eat in this pod, they do all their stuff in this little pot, and he's dunking his coconut creams in mead. You're weird, dude. Which results in creativity. But this voice will periodically give them challenges, and they have to do it. Like, for instance, they'll have like these really, they'll have like clothespins, and they'll be like, "Okay, you gotta put a clothespin somewhere on your body." So they do it. They put it on their arm or something like that, and then a minute later, it goes, "Now put another clothespin somewhere on your body," and so they do that. Until they quit. So eventually, like, after 45 minutes, they got 45 fucking clothespins on their body, and they're trying to pick spots that won't hurt all that much. And now you think, well, that won't be too bad, because after a while you don't even feel the pinching anymore, because, you know. So what happens is, periodically the computer goes, remove all your clothespins. So they take them all off, the blood rushes back in, and the most agonizing feeling they've ever felt, like, rushes back in. So the gimmick is that they can quit whenever they want, but it's like the lowest two people, the people who quit the fastest are up for elimination. But they don't know, they're all in isolated pods, they can't see each other. So they don't know who's quit already, so they all have to go as long as possible because they don't know who's already quit. So these guys are just fucking killing themselves with these, like, clothespins. Or they call them flesh clips. So that's one example. The other example was they don't feed them anything. Like, not really. Like, they get fed, like, gruel or something like that. So, like, they're all complaining that they're hungry, they're starving. And actually, that's some of... They do reward challenges, so if they do really well, they get a reward, and they get better food. But, yeah, these guys get really shitty food. So they're all complaining, we want better food, we're dying here. So the computer goes, oh, you want better food, do you? Well, that's your next challenge. So they go, we're going to go in a series of rounds. So the first round, you know, it's the lowest two people, you know, have to take a punishment. And so the people who quit their punishments first are up for elimination. So they go, okay, here's the thing. And this little door opens up and there's this huge tub of ice cream. And the computer goes, eat all the ice cream you can. The two lowest people get punished. So they're like, nom, nom, nom. And so they all really foolishly eat all the ice cream they physically can, which is actually a very dumb move, because there's more than one round to this, and they seem to have forgotten that part. But they eat all the ice cream they can. The two people who quit go, oh, like, we can't go anymore. And the computer goes, now you can stay in if you take your punishment. And they go, what's the punishment? So, like, this jar of milk comes down, and it's, like, 2 ounces of milk. And they're like, you have 30 seconds to drink 2 ounces of milk. Go! And so they're like, I don't want... So, like, they're drinking all this fucking milk after, like, 3 fucking scoops of ice cream and all this shit. And they're like, they do it, and they're like, I did it. Oh, God. And the computer goes, round 2! Licorice whips! And so, like, this huge fucking jar of licorice whips come down, and they're like, oh, God. And so, of course, the two people who failed the first time fail the second time. And so, like, they only get through, like, 2 licorice whips, and he goes, your next punishment! Drink 4 ounces of milk in 30 seconds! And so, they drink all the fucking milk. And then they go third round, so they go, third round! Donuts! It's like this big fucking... You know, so it keeps going on. They just fucking torture these people. And again, none of the other contestants know who's already dropped out and who's getting punished. They just know that they only know that they're not in the bottom two if they're not getting punished. It's a really brilliant show because these guys fucking kill themselves. So, yeah.
For dessert, it's only wafer thin.
I was putting off the Arrow minty chocolate... God. I'm gonna throw up. Oh! This looks fucking radioactive. This looks awful. This is not the color of something you would eat. Oh my God. It looks like eating a sponge. Like a kitchen sponge. The smell is intense. Wow. The smell's actually really good. It smells like, you know, those Andes mints, like the little foil wrap mints they always give you on the way out of a restaurant. It smells like that. I mean, it's a mint, you know, of course it is. But this, it smells exactly like that. Ooh. This is my last one, I swear. Ugh.
Lead me to movie reviews, man.
You want to stick to movie reviews? You don't want to do any more? This is like, in a way, this is like worse than the, like, really bad foods that Brad does, because, like, he does his one bad food and then he's done. Whereas this is all, like, really good, but we're fucking gorging ourselves on it, and I can't even stand the taste of it anymore. You know, it's not that bad. It's good.
It's a mint.
It's minty chocolate, yeah. Although, it's a decent flavor, you know. But the thing is, I would never get, like, a huge fuck-off bar of this. I would prefer, like the individually wrapped mints. So, like, if you took a square of this and you foil-wrapped it, that would be a way better move. But it tastes like a restaurant mint, which is good. But yeah, that's... am I missing... I hope I'm not missing anything. Jesus Christ. Okay, so... I don't want to review all the... like, if you want to see what the candy's like, just go back and see, but... final review of the... okay, well, did you try this one?
Yes.
Okay. If you were to pick one between the Ephemera Brew and Highlander Brew, would it matter what kind of food you're eating, do you think?
No.
No? Because they taste... honestly, they taste very similar. It really is... it really is just the bouquet that is at all appreciably different. Whereas both of these just kind of taste like... they taste like beer. To me, they just taste like beer. They taste like... you know, they taste like good beer, because I've had, like... I've had Miller Lite, and it even to me, it tasted like fucking tap water. It tasted like... no, it didn't taste like tap water. It tasted like filthy tap water. You know? But this taste... no, it... okay. I was maybe a little critical of this at first, but it does taste like beer. You know, whereas a lot of American beer doesn't even taste like beer. It just tastes like filth. You know, it tastes like weak filth. But yeah, the mead... I'm sure the mead is very good. It's just... this has to be, like, a really acquired taste. Like, it is so sweet. It is really fucking sweet. Hang on, let me see. Produced and bottled by Bun Ready Mead and Liqueur Company Corporation. Bun Ready Winery, Bun Ready, Clare, Ireland. Discovered by the Irish monks, it was discovered in the Middle Ages... mead soon made its way into the courts of the four kings of Ireland, and the banquet was... no banquet was... is that a typo? It made its way into the courts of Ireland, and Bo Banquet was complete without it. And, yeah. And Bo Banquet was complete without it. Apparently, Bo Banquet was complete without it. This honey-based drink was believed to have powers of virility and fertility, and it became custom for the bride and groom to drink mead for one full moon after their wedding, hence the word honeymoon. I did not know that. Wait. Oh, okay, one full moon after their wedding, so they got hammered on mead afterwards. Okay. In Ireland today, it is still tradition to toast the bride and groom with a glass of mead when they depart on their honeymoon from the wedding feast. Bun Ready Mead can be drunk chilled before meads or as a relaxing after-dinner drink. You may enjoy mead on the rocks with a slice of lemon.
Or with a biscuit.
Or a bratwurst. In the winter, nothing takes the chill out better than mead as a hot toddy. It must be an English thing, or it must be an Irish thing. A hot toddy. And you may wish to drink it at dinner with your chicken, turkey, or game. So we drank it with completely the wrong food. Not just chocolate, but, like, food in general. We should have had it with our chicken, turkey, or game for a hot toddy. Hot toddy. But, hey, you know, we had a banquet, and Bo Banquet was complete without this. But, yeah, like, the mead, man, fuck me, man. That stuff was... I'm sure this is excellent mead. It's just, I can't drink that. It's fucking stiff.
Yeah.
Wow. But, okay, what would you say is the best candy you had? Let's just go that far. Not review every candy bar, but, like, what was the best one?
You got it. I'd say any of the combination of the orange ones, like the biscuits or the
Arrow orange. Again,
it was actually fine.
Again, the Arrow is really good, But I would still prefer it if instead of one big bar, it came as, like, small wrapped food, you know, small wrapped mints or small little wafers. I don't get this. Who's going to, like, what are you going to do? Like, I guess you can reseal it, but it's like, you're going to see someone, like, standing outside the store, like, ah, 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 ah. You know, I don't see that.
In terms of everything else, they're all pretty much things that you've seen before.
No, actually, I didn't find that. Was like, there's some things like Bounty and like Yorkies and Crunchies and
there's some twists on old.
Like the taxis, I guess, are a little different in that they have like the sugar wafers, but a lot of these are just like chocolate bars, but with bubbles that are kind of a softer texture. Honestly, I've never had a I don't want to say never. But this is one of the... Curly Whirly is, like, one of the worst candies I've ever had in my fucking life. Go, Oreo! The chocolate orange stuff was good. I'd never had chocolate orange, like, before that. Milky Bar?
That was the white chocolate.
The white chocolate. So, yeah, a lot of these are just kind of amalgams, but... Honestly, it took us a while to run into one that was kind of the same. Another one... Moro is really good. We didn't open that up, but it's very chocolatey, of course, but it was like eating a brownie, like I said. Taxi was good. Yeah, I thought the arrow with the orange filling, it looked hideous with that fucking, like, it looked like sponge cake uranium, what was that?
I said insulation.
What was it? What was the name of that uranium, though, that was like,
Yellow cake?
Yellow cake uranium. It looked like fucking yellow cake uranium. But it was good. Bounty. A Bounty is a Mounds bar, which is fine. The Lion was good, but the Lion is something you'd get anywhere. A lot of the candies were just like standard chocolate, but with a different texture. Like the Cadbury Swirls or whatever it was like just it was a chocolate bar, but with like that really weird mutant inside. It was like, for some reason, like, Europeans, I guess, or just the UK in general, I don't know, but like, they're very big on like, oh, we all have the same, it's all the same flavor, but the texture, completely different, mate. You know, that's all I can say about that. But yeah, the best one, orange chocolate, surprisingly good. The arrow was surprisingly good. I even liked, oh, what was this one? The one with, like, the Rice Krispie treats and the cookies. No, that's not Wish for Gold. I forget. If you go back in the video, you'll find it. Whatever the one with the Rice Krispie treats, that was good. I hated the coconut creams. Oh, these were good. The Jaffa Cakes, which is, like, the orange, like, what did you say they were like? Like, little cakes? Those were good. Oh, God. And I actually really liked the prawn cocktail. You didn't, but... What was funny was I was really afraid I was really going to like these to the point where I got hopelessly addicted and started to, like, import the stuff. I'm not there. But if I saw this in the store, like, in these, like, okay, like, if I went to, like, a Quiznos or something like that, and you know how they give you a bag of chips, I would have this. It's an occasional thing, but I would have this. You got to get this in the States, man. Prawn cocktail potato chips. Working with the Carbon Trust. That's all I got. So, I gotta get back to work on Ultima 9, and before you say it's taking too long, I'd like to see you try to edit through 13 games of Ultima footage, totaling about a... How many hours do you think that would be, 13 games? Let's see, they took 40... Let's assume the older ones took like 3 or 4... Let's be light, say 150 hours worth of footage. That's how many fucking hours of footage I gotta comb through, so... Anyway. I'm gonna go wrap this candy up, so it doesn't go to waste. Oh my God. What have we done? I need more Highlander Brew. I might actually crack this open just to wash the fucking chocolate out of my mouth. Anyway. I suppose you don't want to do any more of these if this... Oh, wait, no. Kit Kat Chunky was really good. But only if you can get the European chocolate or whatever. Some people tell me that, like, the Swiss chocolate is like, I had Austrian chocolate and that was fucking awesome, but the Swiss chocolate was apparently like the best that you can ever get anywhere. So must try it sometime. But anyway, oh, thank you guys for those of you who actually gave me some of the candy. Thank you to Demon de Hagen, who gave me, I can't remember what bar she gave me. She gave me like 5 or 6. Thank you to the fan, if you see that painting behind me. Ooh, that's actually, you can't see it up close, but it's actually called The Quickening, which is, it's basically, there's a guy in the middle of like a lightning storm, a blue lightning storm. There's a guy holding a sword in the middle of it, like he's undergoing the quickening. So that was actually really hard to pack, and you try packing that in luggage. Not easy, you know? Especially since I only brought one bag, and I had to check it, so... It actually came through surprisingly with no damage, but that's because I fucking, like, shrouded it in, like, basically my old clothes. I'm sorry about that. Although, what's funny about that is it's not really a traditional painting. It's kind of got this funny feel to it where it's got, like, this black canvas, but the paint is all raised up on it. So it's kind of like, it's almost like a, again, this is my ignorance of artwork, but it's almost like it's been screen printed. It hasn't been, I know that, but it's like, you know how sometimes when you feel a shirt and there's a pattern on the shirt, you can feel like it's raised up from the shirt. It's almost like that, where it's like almost, I don't know, it's really cool though. I appreciate the painting. I appreciate everyone. Thank you to BroCon for flying me out to Ireland and letting me enjoy your exquisite cuisine of candies. I had so many candies I had to declare them at customs. They didn't give a shit. They're like, I filled out my form, I was like 60 euro worth of candy, and they're like, whatever, they slide through. But yeah, thank you for the ephemera apple beer, which somebody gave me, and thank you for the Highlander Canadian brew, because Highlanders do not only come from Scotland, they come from the Highlands of Canada as well.
Lots of different places.
Lots of different places. Hey, you know, he was a, what was his name, Nash? he was Nash for many years. So who's to say that Connor McLeod didn't start a brewery in Canada before coming to New York City and becoming an antique? No, he could have started a Scottish microbrewery. It says Scottish ale, which I find really hard to believe. I would just think the Scottish would drink something a lot stiffer than this. I don't know. I honestly pictured, like, drinking this and being like, oh, God, dark, stiff. Like, you know, the kind of, like, you know, there's, like, that really dark fucking Guinness that you could basically stand a fork up in? I honestly thought it would be kind of like that, where, like, you always picture, well, okay, this is really offensive, but you know how you always picture, like, in D&D, the dwarves are always Scottish, like fucking Gimli. Although, I never did that. I always did Norse. I did, like, Norsemen. Because, like, when you think of dwarves, you think the guys with the big fucking horned helmets. You don't think Scotsmen. But, you know, when you think of, like, the Scottish dwarf, you think of them drinking that fucking, like, sludgy beer that's really, you know, really good, but, like, nobody else could drink it. That's what I pictured this would be. And it's just kind of a beer. Anyway, we're going to take off. This has gone on way too long, and I'm probably going to throw up. So thanks for watching!